What's up, guys?
What's up, guys? Welcome back to our channel, and thank you for watching again.
So, in this video, we're going to talk about the algorithm of Amazon. And we're going to get a little bit technical, but this information will be so valuable for as well beginner sellers as advanced sellers. So, guys, let's dive into it. Alright guys, so we're going to talk about the algorithm of Amazon and how to play with the algorithm. We're going to walk over a few steps, and first of all, it's really good to know the algorithm is changing always. Amazon is always developing their platform. There will be always different variables that you have to keep in mind when you're optimizing your listing, for example. As well, Amazon is testing your listing by placement on their page to see what is the best placement for your listing to give the customers of Amazon the best experience on their website. So guys, first of all, we're going to talk about the ranking factors of Amazon and what is the most important for you as a seller. The sales is actually the most important. The Amazon platform is an e-commerce website and they just want to have the most amount of sales on their website. So one of the tools that we're using to check the sales, if we search for example whiteboard pens over here, and you can just get your Jungle Scout out and check all the sales of your competitors and if you are able to compete with them. As we say over here, Amazon just wants to get the most money and give as well the best customer experience, so they want just the most sales possible. And if you don't get any sales with your listing, something is going wrong and Amazon will not be likely to rank you on a good position. As well, your listing optimization is really important for your ranking factors. If your price is way too high for the product that you're selling and nobody's buying your product, then you will not get a high rank. Do you have a complete listing? Are you using the full potential of images that you're able to use? And do you have the right sizes of images? So are your images zoomable? You need to have at least 1,000 pixels wide if you want to have zoomable images on Amazon. I will just show you a little example over here. So this product got really nice zoomable images. People can really view the products in a good way. And if you have a registered brand, you can as well have videos over here to give the best experience for the people that are watching your listing. The next thing is keyword relevancy. Make your backend so complete as possible. Fill in all the possible information that you can give to your customers. Are you trying to rank for relevant keywords? And do you have some primary keywords and some secondary keywords filled down in your backend as well? Then you got your account health. Do you have a good seller rating? Are you answering on reviews? Are you answering questions of people that are asking questions on your listing? For example, over here, this listing got nice question and answers and they answered all of them as well. And your inventory is really important. If you're getting out of inventory every time, Amazon will not like this because they can not show your listing all the time and you'll be on, you'll be off, you'll be selling, but in the end, Amazon will not like this if you're always getting out of inventory. Then you got the reviews. Do you have a good amount of reviews? Are the ratings good? And do you have a good average of the reviews? If you only got bad reviews, people will not be likely to buy your product and Amazon will not like to rank you on the highest position. So guys, the next thing is click-through rate. So what is click-through rate? When you're searching on an Amazon page, like this over here, and people just scrolling down, how many people will click on your listing? If not a lot of people are clicking on your listing, then Amazon will just rank you lower, 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 and lower. But this is one of the things you can optimize really easy. Just test out some other pictures and check if your click-through rate is getting higher. Where can you analyze this? If you just go to the Seller Central and check on reports, then go to business reports and check by child item, you can see per item what your click-through rate is. How to optimize? Guys, just get better pictures. If your click-through rate is really bad, just get better pictures and give in once a clear overview what you're selling, and then people will be more likely to click on your listing. Then on your listing, you got the conversion rate, and that brings us to the next point. The conversion rate is the amount of people that are coming on your listing and that are buying your product when they were on your listing. You can as well analyze this in Seller Central, go to reports and business reports, check by child item and check out your conversion rate over here. As well, there are a lot of things that you can optimize on your listing, like your title, different colors of your product, for example, the images, your bullet points, and all the information that you're giving with the question and answer, your product description, some other variables over here, like additional information and technical details, and of course your reviews. So guys, now you know the ranking factors of your products, we're going to get a little bit more technical. We're getting a little bit more nerdy, and we're going to talk about the algorithm of Amazon. One of the past updates was the A9 update. Amazon is always giving A with a number for their updates. And over here, we're going to talk about the algorithm A9 update and what it actually was. So guys, the Amazon algorithm update A9, it's really important to optimize your listing for all the things that they updated. First of all, we got the product research box. Over here, if we go on Amazon and you would just type down a keyword, you will see here the dropdown, and they optimize this. So it's really important that you will fill in into your backend all the keywords that you want to rank for. For example, here with whiteboard pens, you got whiteboard markers. There are a lot more synonyms actually. If you just want to get some inspiration for the synonyms, go on Jungle Scout and check here the associated keywords, and you will see already all the associated keywords that are for your product. That's why Jungle Scout can be really handy to check out. As well, within this update, the sales performance history is really important. Are you getting steady sales? Because Amazon really likes to have steady sales. And if you got only steady sales, then you'll be more likely to get a good rank with your product listing. Then we got the text match relevancy. Is your product listing all matching? So your title, your bullet point, your description, and as well your Q&A, your reviews, your backend keywords, everything needs to be clear for Amazon. You're communicating with an algorithm, you're communicating with Amazon, so everything has to get in one straight line. If you're only to put down some weird keywords, you will not be likely to rank good. Then we got the price. Are you playing a lot with your price? If you're selling for one day for 20 euros and the other day for 50 euros, Amazon don't like it when you play around all the time, because they will not know what will be your best position, and then you will be not likely to rank on the best position. Availability of stock. So as we already said before, the availability of stock is really important, because if you're getting out of stock all the time, Amazon will not like it, because they're not able to show your listing all the time and to sell products. So if you're getting out of stock every time, Amazon will not like it. Then we got the possibility to enhance brand content. This is actually only possible for people who registered their brand on Amazon. And if you registered your brand, you'll be able to show videos and enhance brand content. So guys, over here we got an example. This whiteboard marker brand has registered their brand on Amazon, and they're able to fill in enhanced brand content. And you will see this is quite an outstanding listing, because they can use nice images and some good text over here. And it's really nice as well for people to see this on a product listing, because it just gives a clear overview. Guys, these were the main key points of the A9 Amazon algorithm update. But they already have an A10 update as well. And this is a really important update. So let's get over it. So guys, then we got the Amazon algorithm update A10. Advertising is still really important to Amazon. Amazon got a business model and they want to earn money and give a great customer experience. And money and customer experience is actually what this algorithm update is about. Amazon really likes it when you are spending money on advertising on their platform. And as well, for your organic ranks, this is one of the things that Amazon really likes. Then we got seller history. This got even more important. We already talked about this with the A9 update, but as well for the A10 update. Amazon wants steady sales. And if they can give their customers a good product listing that are having steady sales, they will know that it's a valuable product listing for Amazon. Feedback is really important. Do you get good reviews? Do you answer all your questions and answers on your product listing page? Because Amazon just wants to see the interaction with you and the customers as well, because then you're giving a good customer experience on the platform. So guys, authority is so important, because Amazon wants to have trustable sellers on their website. So this is also about the ratings and question and answers, and as well your seller rating. are you a trustable seller? Because if you got trustworthy, then Amazon knows that you're valuable for them as well, because you are giving a good customer experience on their website. The next point is real reviews. We're actually going to make a video about this because Amazon is cleaning up a lot of fake reviews. It's harder to get good reviews on your product these days. You cannot just give everybody a coupon and get some reviews, because Amazon will delete reviews very fast these days. We're going to talk about this and give a good explanation how you can get the most reviews in a short time in another video. But this is one of the key points of the algorithm updates as well. So keep in mind that you get real reviews. So guys, I just put down here, be like a call center or hire someone. And with this I mean, be good for your customers. People are buying from you, but give a good customer experience, because this is really what Amazon is all about. They want to give the best customer experience. So if you're answering all your messages in your seller center really good, all the questions and answers and all the reviews as well, like interact with your customers, because they will really like it and rank you as well higher. So guys, then we have four more points for this algorithm update. The click-through rates, the off-site sales, the organic sales, and the internal sales. Amazon really likes it when people from another platform, for example, Facebook advertising or your own website, are getting on Amazon and they're buying products. Because every time when this happens, somebody will go from another channel, another platform, another website, onto the Amazon website, and you just give a referral link. So you're pushing users to the Amazon website and they will get more users. Eventually they will get more sales from it, and this is one of the things that they really like, because they also want to grow their platform and they just want everybody to buy on Amazon. Alright guys, so just a little recap. We talked about everything that you can optimize on your listing to get your listing on a good position of Amazon. We talked about the A9, and it's really important to keep in mind that everything is a ranking factor. Have a complete listing, rank for the right keywords, and just make it logical. Talk with the algorithm, like communicate with the algorithm of Amazon and show them what your listing is all about. Everything needs to match. Yeah, make your listing complete and outstanding. If you got the possibilities, check for enhanced brand content like we got over here. And yeah, communicate with the algorithm of Amazon, because if you're getting like one straight line into your product listing, you want to rank for the right keywords, then they will be more likely to rank you on a good position. The 8th algorithm was for us actually all about trustworthy, get real reviews, don't get spammy, and be an authoritative seller. Connect with your customer, hire somebody to be like a call center for you, answer the mails, answer the reviews, answer the Q&As, and be a really authoritative seller, communicate with everybody, and Amazon really likes to see it. This is a long-term investment. If you're investing in communicating with your customers, you will get more reviews, more seller ratings as well, and this will definitely impact your sales as well. So guys, a little conclusion. You really can see that Amazon is all about trustworthy, and we don't see this as a threat. We see this as a massive opportunity. This can be a little bit more work upfront, but if you're communicating with your customers in the right way, you will get definitely more sales. This will be the right time to start off with Amazon. Why? Because Amazon is cleaning up all the bad reviews. They really want the trustworthy. So this can be the best time to start off with your Amazon. As well, for people who are already selling on Amazon, this will be the best time to change your game. Get a new game, get a new strategy, and get real reviews, connect with your customers, and get more sales, better ranks, and play with the algorithm of Amazon, guys. Guys, I hope I gave you some really valuable information, and if you have any questions about the algorithm of Amazon, please comment it down here below. And thank you all for watching. I hope to see you in the next video.